I just saw my response to Mujahid Okwasare Chijoke Paul, okay, Efufe. And I just laughed. He said my attention was drawn to a 19-minute video released by Alhaji Asare Dokpo where he mentioned my name, Igwe nickname, 3 times. In the video, he accused and labeled all supporters of Buhari traitors and those not in support of the senseless action of IPOB sectionist group led by Cone Master Nnamdi Kanu as traitors. I am very surprised. The video is there, and he talked about, yes, you are a traitor, there's no doubt about it. And if you call Nnamdi Kanu a con man, Chijoke, you are the con man by excellence. As you organized, how did you get into the pocket of Timi Prince-Silva? You got into the pocket of Timi Prince-Silva when you people launched one of these 419 chat groups you call Facebook friends of Timi Prince-Silva, and you got into his pocket and start to dig holes inside his pocket and start to collect what you wanted to collect. And then you talk about being Igbo and talking for Igbos. I wonder what you've been talking for Igbos for. And how that you talk for Igbos that brought anything. I don't want to talk about my younger brother and friend Timi Prince-Silva, but I really want to say that there are people who hold political office and they are easily cajoled by characters like you, who today are looking for, because if you shout at the top of your voice against your own people, abused Nnamdi Kanu, they will say this is one of the amenable Igbos. This is one of the Igbos that love Nigeria. This is one of the Igbos that we can recruit and use effect as an effective tool against their people. So they take you on. And that's what you want. You want to gain at the expense of your people. But you gain, you raise certain issues. And I want to really dwell on these issues and address them surgically. I want to take them to the surgical theater and dissect them surgically. Number one of the issues you raised, he said, people like me do not have the moral ground to speak for humanity. And I have moral ground and speaking for humanity in what sense? I am Alhaji Mujahid Okwasare. I have a pedigree that has lasted 300 years. Check my history. My father, Honorable Justice Melford Goodhead, his father was Dokubo Wilkinson Goodhead, the first postmaster, a missionary, a teacher, from the family of young George Goodhead in Bukuma that has produced, as you are talking, has produced people in different spheres of life. Judicial officers, professors, military men, administrators in different spheres of life. You can go and check the record. My grandmother, the mother of my father, was Princess Okukuba. She's a direct descendant of King Amakri, who had ruled Calabari from 1669 to date. And in all treaties, in all European records, you will see. My mother, Bekinware, is the daughter of Idonboyeku, the one but last head of the Hari group of houses in Calabari. And the Hari group of houses include even Efulefu like Tamdev West, mother, Omaloba and my mother are the same father, were first cousins. So there are several people. My father, Honorable Justice Melford Goodhead, gave me an opportunity. And I did not have any moral issue. In my 53 years in this world, I have never been convicted. I've been arrested and detained 74 times by the Nigerian government. Have been taken to court on several occasions. I had never been convicted anywhere in the world. So what morality? What is the parameter, the scale on which you're judging morality? What is the parameter with which, Chijoke, you are judging morality? Because if a man had been taken to court, lawyers have argued, and in all that, he has never been convicted once. Never. If you are put through that crucible, if you are tried in that furnace, I don't think you come out alive. I don't think you come out alive. I had never been a cheerleader in my life. So talking about morality, you don't have anything to stand before me. My clothes are as white as snow. They have not been tainted with all the attempts to taint them. I am one of the most persecuted, prosecuted, arrested people on the surface of the earth. And in all, I have never been convicted. In Nigeria, Obafemi Awolowo was arrested. He was convicted. General Olusegun Obasanjo was arrested. He was convicted. There are several others that have been arrested and have been convicted because of whatever reason. But what I'm telling you, with all the hate, with all the death you talk about, nobody has been able to convict me. No court of law. Now, number two, you talk about the desire of a man. The issues raised by Nnamdi Kanu and others, what is going about them? You want to ingratiate yourself to the Buhari and others so that you will be given one small appointment where you will get the crumbs that fall from the master's table. You cannot sit on the table with them to eat. So how is Nnamdi Kanu a con man? What Nnamdi Kanu is saying has been said over and over by several other people. And he did not make them con men. So how does Nnamdi Kanu saying it make him a con man? It's a question you have to answer. Chijoke, you have to answer. So if Ezife said it is not a con man, if Modu said it is not a con man, but if Nnamdi Kanu said that he's a con man, how does Nnamdi Kanu say it that makes him a con man? And he said, I should have picked my gun to go to Abia State. I am not a member of IPOB. And I have never shied away from picking guns to fight, confront the Nigerian state. I've never done that. That you know, in all my arrests and trial, it has always been that I've picked gun and I've said that I'll fight the Nigerian state. I lead by example. IPOB has are ideologies that are different from my ideology. IPOB believe that her ideologies is that they cannot pick up arms. They have adopted the Guardian, Mahatma Gandhi ideology of peaceful engagement. I don't believe in it. And so I cannot impose my will on them. I cannot impose my will on them that they must accept my will. You went on to say that I am a Muslim. Yes, that I am a Muslim. Islam has nothing to do with northerners. If they are Muslim and they say La ilaha illallah, wa la hawla sharika la, wa ashhadu anna Muhammadan abduhu wa rasuluhu, if they say that,
They are Muslims, but their actions and their behavior must also hate their iman, their faith as Muslims. Does he hate their iman and their faith as Muslims? Does their behavior show that they are Muslims? So if somebody says he's a Muslim, he hates me as an Ijaw man, he comes to my land to take that which belongs to me, I should say because he's a Muslim, it's okay? No. So if mosques are burnt, churches have been burnt, mosques have been burnt in and out, Boko Haram is burning mosques, and nobody is in support of it. That mosque should be born. I came out to condemn it. Not because of you. Not because I'm afraid of anybody. Not because I'm afraid of that thing. That thing you call Buhari. No. No. I'm not afraid of him. I know that at 53. I know that this is a battle Buhari cannot win. Mark my word. Mark it today. This is a battle Buhari cannot win. And mark my word that you will run. At the end of the day, you will surely run. Chijoke, you will surely run because you have nowhere to hide. You will not have anywhere to hide. You cannot betray your people and support the killing of your people and expect that you'll be forgiven and you'll be brought back. It will be difficult for the people to forgive your sin and your treachery against them. So, how? IPOB members who are seen in Nnamdi Kanu's place. They turned themselves in Biafran, in Signal, Panathinaikos. The people who you display attacking bosses and so on, there is none of them that has anything that leads them to IPOB. None of them. Because when these events were unfolding, both Muslims in Port Harcourt, Muslim imams of several mosques were calling me, and I was communicating with the leadership of IPOB. In fact, the leadership of IPOB asked me to come. Even Moshe Mefo said it on Radio Biafra, and commended me. The leadership of IPOB asked me to come out. Please, come out and call our people. They will respect you. They will listen to you. I was communicating with them, the leaders of Directorate of State, different leaders all over the world. I was communicating with them and telling them, please, we should not descend to their level. And imams were calling me. My wife, Awa, who is a Fulani woman, called me from France. Ah, something must be done. And I came out to speak. Not at your own prompting. Not at the prompting of the thing you call Buhari. There's nothing. He will not escape it. Mind you, we arrest. What is arrest? If I am arrested, that is their threat. That is their, but he will not escape this one. Definitely he won't. Not mind this one. That, so it is a lie. It is a total lie. It is a total lie that IPOB members were responsible for attacking people. And I believe that the people who attacked, we know how intelligence works, we know how the military works, we know how why they went to the front of Nnamdi Kanu's house, we know that they went there to instigate so they can set up people to go and kill people. The same way Buhari and his group set up Boko Haram, funded Boko Haram. So we know that they will do these things. So I will not be surprised that there is a few people, columnists they put there to instigate people to riot, and at the end of the day, they now say it is IPOB. That's what they wanted to achieve. What was the need of the Python dance to? Boko Haram is waiting for them there. Fulani herdsmen are killing people in Enugu State, in everywhere. You have not come out. You have not spoken about it. You say you are an Igbo man 100%. Because you are an Igbo man 100%. But when Fulani people killed people in Enugu, you did not hear. You did not talk. Your voice was not heard. Shame on you. If people like you are hippos, then hippos should cry. They should weep. They should weep and cry. They should pour hatches on their body and weep. Jesus, if people like you are hippos, then the evil nation is bereaved of people without. Evil nation is bereaved of people without. You are nobody but a total con man. A cold-blooded, heartless, wicked traitor. In that Nnamdi Kanu got some money from Malaysia, another place, 2 million. I love. First, I have never met Nnamdi Kanu in my life. I spoke to Nnamdi Kanu on the phone. Before Nnamdi Kanu went to prison, he was abusing me on his radio. And somebody, a journalist, came to interview me from the Gaiga, an Igbo man. Said Nnamdi Kanu is abusing you. Sometime in 2014 or 2015, Nnamdi Kanu is abusing you on Radio Biafra. And I said, he tuned Radio Biafra. Luckily that day Nnamdi Kanu was talking all sorts of things about me, Tombolo and so on. And then, how is it if Nnamdi Kanu is talking about me? What? I'm just an individual. If Nnamdi Kanu is actually committed to Biafra, then he's misguided in some area. If he's committed to Biafra, the ends will justify the means. When we reach there, we will know. If all of us have... The fellow looked at me and said, I've never seen a woman being like you before. I refuse to talk against Nnamdi Kanu. I never met him. Even when he came out of prison, he has made overtures to come and see me. Even when the job leaders were called, when he said he was coming to meet the job leaders in Port Harcourt, they specifically came to Inegua and met me and said, "Our president, you must be around." Kala Dagene, one of the founders of Masop came to me with Osimini. "You have to be present at the meeting." I told them, "I'm busy, I can't be present." I did everything to make sure that I did not have a face-to-face meeting with Nnamdi Kanu. Not because I hate him, because I feel like it was not the time for two of us to meet face-to-face. And so many of the people who are close to me, everybody was saying, "Why, you and Nnamdi should meet, you and our leader should meet now, please." And I said, "Wait, it's not yet time." So Nnamdi Kanu, 2 million. Nnamdi Kanu, younger brother, had come to meet me. We exchanged pleasantries. I've spoken to Nnamdi Kanu's wife. I've spoken to almost all the leaders. They sought for me. I talked to them. And in this period of crisis, even as late as this time, I speak to them on the phone. I continually speak to them. So it is blah, blah, dash. Total from the fragment of the imagination of an inhabitant of hell for you to say Nnamdi Kanu brought money. What is $2 million? You think $2 million is big money? You are calling $2 million. I just laugh at you. I derer. Chijokaki derer, bra. You think everybody is like you? Everybody will be bought by money. I'm a Muslim. It would have been easier to ingratiate myself to these people. Find out. The Minister for Education, Adamu Adamu, is like a senior brother to me. He's very close to me. So if Buhari is in power, he was Buhari as a special assistant when he was in PTF. I would have been going there. I was close to him. Or is it the Minister of Abuja, Mohamed Bello? Or is it the Minister for Communication, Chichu? Who? How many of the people that are there that I cannot gain access to? Is it Udoh Udoma that went to South Africa with me? To attend the Earth Summit. So what are we talking about? I have assets. Or is it Timipuri Silva, your man? Or is it Ngige? That I cannot have access to. The APC you are joining, you knew when I was leader of ACN in Rivers and Bayelsa. The party was in my hand. ACN was in my hand in Rivers and Bayelsa. That I have said so many things against Igbos. I can pass as one of the founders of MOSOP. Because when MOSOP started and Owazirike came to Port Harcourt, we were with him. Uchokoko, Kalada Jelly, Dr. Menike Wanu, Mommy Kate, Bas. We were with him. So what are you trying to say? That Shell, has Shell headquarter ever been in Port Harcourt? Shell headquarter has always been in Lagos. Has Totafina headquarters ever been in Port Harcourt? It has always been in Lagos. So what are you talking about? Has Chevron Texaco been in Port Harcourt? It has always been in Lagos. Which kidnapping? Your government should take me to court. All the charges they made for my treason trial, did you see any kidnapping there? They say I levy war against the Nigerian state and attempt to overthrow the government, the legitimate government of the Nigerian state. These were the main camp charges against me. I levy war against, go and Google it. So if you are talking about morality, I stand tall among freedom fighters. I don't ascribe anything to myself. Obasanjo told my wife, which you know very well, Carol Mamaluta, told her that he, good luck, use your husband to climb to where he is. What has he done for your husband? If there was anybody, I don't want to talk about good luck, but it's coming out now. The names of the people who shopped money are coming out. Have you heard my name? You have friends, go and ask them. Have you heard my name? I don't want to talk about anything concerning good luck. Because as far as I'm concerned, that was his nation. He did his best. In the house, I can talk about him. This is not the time to criticize good luck in the public. He has done his own. But what you will use to know about people who have eaten, who have done, who did, is you will see my names now. Have you heard my name? The millions of dollars, good Lord, used to chuck in my mouth. Why is it not coming out? My dollar is different from the dollar of other people. Is my dollar different from the dollar of other people that they are catching them? Why is my dollar not coming out? Because I respect my name. I know who I am. I am an Amakri. I'm so proud of it. I can never, even my friends who read this, even those in the APC, they will be laughing at you. Even Timmy Brisiva will be laughing at you. Masaloko will laugh at you. All of them will laugh at you. Say, now, President, they talk about, leave that matter. That's what they will tell you. They know me. That even against myself, I will stand up and talk when it comes to corruption, when it comes to taking that which does not belong to me. But I was well trained. My grandmother, Princess Okokoba, gave me the best of training that anybody can have in the world. Since I was born, I've never picked anything on the street. I've never picked anything on the ground that does not belong to me. After the war, while growing up, there were these stories that people went out, they picked something, they became chicken, they became goat. And my grandmother asked, if they don't pick, that thing they're picking is it their one? If they don't pick, would they become chicken and goat? My grandmother who told me that do not look at those who are above you, look at the people who are below you and give thanks to God, for it is only you who know how you got to where you are. It is only they know the number of people they killed, the number of sacrifices they made. There are people who still have honor and integrity as their stepping stone. Check all the contracts, all the names. I never went to them to beg for contract, even doing good luck. When they give and give and give, and they say, "Chair Presto, this one, if you give Presto money, now come go carry and go buy you." That's what they say about me. So, Igwe, highly silver-rated palace, You are not the kind of person I would have joined issued with, because I know you are a traitor. And I know that at the dawn of the day, when Biafra will be freed, you will pay for it. There will be no two ways about it. You surely pay. Whether I am around or not, I don't run from battle. You said I invested in Republic of Benin. Go and study revolution everywhere. How many South African black businessmen who are supporters of ANC invested in South Africa? How many Palestinian Arabs who are in support of PLO are investing in Gaza or in the West Bank? It's not conducive to invest. I don't own a single house. I don't own a single house in Abuja. So all these lies about owning houses, it's just the fragment of your imagination, or you manufactured it from the hell to which you belong to. The hell which you belong to. So for as far as I'm concerned, you can go and check. I don't own a single house. Even in Port Harcourt, I just own one small house. In Warri, I own one small house. So I invested. I would have gone elsewhere all over the world to invest. I invested very close to home because I think that my investment would be safe. But I don't even think it will be safe. Look, let me tell you, nothing matters to me in this life. All my investment and everything can be sacrificed. I brought people in to train them. And I'm training a lot of young people, including Northerners, in my school. Northern Muslims, Gambarese, Hausas, Nubes, free of charge in my school. Writing while I'm passing the exams. So Igwe Palos, you don't talk about people. You are a traitor. Any of our person who support this butcher, Muhammad Buhari, is a traitor and will be counted as a traitor. And except you do penitence and crawl and roll on the ground to beg the people for forgiveness, if you consider it worthwhile that you not go back to your treasury, then you'll be forgiven. I am not on the same pedestal with you. I have a badge of honor. I'm not a cheerleader. I'm not people who get into people's pocket by praising them and calling them names. If there were people who criticize Goodluck openly and before him in meetings, I would be first. And the closest person with me, I'll be 100%. The closest person with me will not even be up to 10%. Those who have access to Goodluck and who are telling him duties, telling him the truth. And that's why today you cannot see my name in anything, in any of the things I accuse people of, because I am above board.